If you have ever wondered how to create painted or stylized 3D art, I invite you to dive into the Spline Brush tool that I developed to generate strokes on a mesh. The concept is quite simple. You need to draw curves on top of any mesh surface. This tool is powered by geometry nodes with relatively small noodles. It allows you to customize its modifier with a lot of parameters and play with many useful techniques and possibilities. So, let's take a closer look. After you installed asset library or append manually strokes asset, you can see the core of the tool, curves and UV layout. UV layout is a simple plane with UV map on it and a bunch of UV islands of rectangular shape. If you want to make this from scratch, add a plane object and assign geometry nodes modifier from asset library called UV layout. Then need to add some splines. The process is similar, just drag and drop modifier called Spline Brush cards or append it directly from modifier stack. So when you have some cards, pick material in modifier that contains atlas texture and connect it cards UV vector from brush info node. After that, you can pick UV layout object in modifier. Loop cut plane or edit UV islands to fit atlas texture sections. Toggle flip UV checkbox if you are atlas oriented horizontally. And if you want to have specific rows or columns from texture atlas, remove unnecessary faces with unwanted UVs. Let me show you another example with this ornamental trim sheet. The logic is simple. You have UV mapped layout that can be edited via UV editor or sliced directly in edit mode. But the most important thing is to properly unwrap in UV editor, because it's based on the aspect ratio of the UV island. In other words, UV layout corresponds to the ratio of radius to length from strokes cards. After loop cutting, I left only one trim to make custom layout. The workflow is to duplicate the current layout as many times as you want to have sections for the brush. Shorten your future sections along the length of the trim sheet one by one. Just delete and dissolve all unnecessary edges. When trims are done, you can simply duplicate it and offset UV layout to make variations of brush presets. Of course, there is a better way to do this incremental step in UV mapping, but this is just an example to show manual possibilities. If everything is set up properly, you can see trims are automatically snapped to the nearest UV island according to the aspect ratio of each spline. And you can join different layouts to distribute various mapping on your brush preset. So after that, you can freely relink all your brushes in the scene to different layouts. So, layout object is done, and now you can draw some strokes on your mesh. But strokes are not oriented properly, because they have to be linked to the surface. Then, need to apply some shaders on cards. In Surface Image Texture tab, you can find 5 image slots that transfer image textures from surface based on its UV map. Below, you can find the blur parameter to make the color sampling more painterly. So I made some spline painting and wanna show you a few useful techniques available in my tool. Let's start from surface normal offset. This value offsets each spline based on surface normals, and you may find useful to tweak randomness as well. In addition to surface techniques, you can shrink wrap cards on nearest surface and preserve normal offset and initial positions, as well as completely wrapped cards. And the most interesting thing in normal offset is custom mask that can be drawn in texture painter and be based on surface UV maps. This mask is just a factor that multiplies offset values by 0 or 1. It's pretty handy when you want to mask specific region or even decrease its strength with gray values. Then go spline parameters like radius, resolution, relax or smoothing options. All make splines look better. Next options are endpoints extension. You can extend star or endpoints separately, and then mask specific regions in texture paint as well. And my favorite parameters locates in the guided scattering tab. And this checkbox converts original curves into a bunch of small cards based on length and radius densities. Scattering seed can change each frame with it per frame factor. And the last development included in Spline Brush called Camera Space. This is additional modifier that supports camera cooling and projects brush cards into camera space with some refraction shaders on it. Projection checkbox accessible in cards modifier from camera tab for optimization reasons. And camera cooling checkbox locates in the new modifier. The last thing is the refraction strokes shader. It has a few parameters to play, but the most important is smudging factor. This factor affects refraction normals and blends mesh behind it more painterly. Eventually, you may wonder, so how to bake the result on textures and mesh? Spline Brush Cards modifier can be attached to curve object or mesh object. The easiest way is using curves, but the geometry nodes is a constructive modifier that builds a mesh object. That's the reason why you can't apply modifier on curve object. So to fix that issue, you can always convert visual geometry to mesh. Before color attribute baking, you need to pack UVs manually or procedurally in Spline Brush modifier. Turn on checkbox Pack UV in Modifier Material tab. Then you can apply modifier if it's a mesh object, or apply visual geometry to mesh in viewport for curves object. As you can see, we have editable mesh, so let's move to baking. In Object Data Properties, there is a bunch of attributes generated inside geometry nodes. For proper baking, we need to convert card's packed UV attribute in actual mesh UV map. Just pick 2D vector conversion data type, and that's all. Then create a new empty texture, and check if there is a card's packed UV. I'm using cycles amid baking on selected image texture, but you can bake color attributes in any convenient way you know. Then plug to shader output color attributes. They all stored in SB info node and was transferred from surface previously. So the very last step is select an empty image in shader graph and bake color attribute. I hope it was informative overview of Spline Brush tool. This is my very first long-awaited release of my Blender tool, so I would appreciate your feedback and support. See you to the next updates.